characteristics you possess are genetic, that is, determined by your genes. Genes are segments of DNA that code for specific traits, for example, height, skin color, hair texture, or blood type. Genes are found on chromosomes. Human beings have 46 chromosomes in the nucleus of each cell in the body. These 46 chromosomes were inherited from the individual's parents, 23 from the mother, and 23 from the father. As a human being, you have 46 chromosomes, 23 from your mom, and 23 from your dad. The unique combination of chromosomes you received is what makes you a unique individual, different from every other person on the planet. If you have brothers or sisters, they also received 23 chromosomes from each of your parents, but the combination of chromosomes they received will be different from yours, which is what makes you unique from your siblings. The exception to this is identical twins, who are essentially genetic clones of each other and possess the exact same set of chromosomes from their parents. So to summarize, unless you are an identical twin, you have a completely different combination of genes than any other person on the planet. You inherited your genes from your parents, and you would, in turn, pass some of those genes on to the children you might someday have. The process of passing genetic information on from one generation to the next is called heredity. Many traits that you inherited are visible and can be determined by examining your physical appearance. For instance, you can usually tell by looking at someone what their genes say for traits like hair color and height. Some traits, on the other hand, are not so apparent. Blood type, for example, is a trait determined by genes that you cannot tell just by looking at someone. A blood test would be necessary to determine that genetic trait. Some genes even code for certain health problems. Celiac disease is one example of a genetic disorder. People with celiac disease are severely allergic to gluten, a protein found in wheat and certain other grains. When a person with celiac disease eats gluten, their immune system attacks their small intestine. The damage to the small intestine causes severe digestive issues, like cramping, diarrhea, and bloating, as well as other symptoms like skin rashes and seizures. Additionally, the damage to the intestines prevents the body from being able to absorb nutrients, which can lead to a host of other health problems like anemia and other forms of malnourishment. Yet another health problem caused by genetics is cystic fibrosis. This life-threatening disease is caused by a mutated gene that leads to the buildup of mucus in the lungs and digestive organs. Mucus in the lungs clogs airways, leading to infections, lung damage, and eventually respiratory failure. Mucus in the digestive organs prevents the release of digestive enzymes that aid in nutrient digestion and absorption. Advancements in medicine have led to treatments that can allow a person with cystic fibrosis to live up to 40 years old. However, there is still no cure. As you can probably guess, it is important to know if genetic disorders like these run in your family. Like any genetic trait, they are inherited from parents and could be passed on to children. Genetic counselors are health professionals that study the family histories of patients with inherited disorders. They use their knowledge of genetics to determine the probability of transmitting genetic diseases. Genetic counselors help families by discussing symptoms and treatments, as well as family planning strategies. Punnett squares are tables that help to predict the likelihood of inheriting genetic traits. You might have studied them in your biology class. To do their job, genetic counselors use Punnett squares and other tools like pedigrees. A pedigree is like a family tree that tracks a specific genetic trait. Circles represent females, while squares represent males. Horizontal lines represent a couple who have produced children, and the children are connected to the parents by vertical lines. In this particular pedigree, individuals affected by the genetic disorder are coded in red. Blue shapes represent individuals who do not have the genetic disorder. Most families do not have genetic health problems. Furthermore, there are other health issues that are not genetic, but can still affect multiple members of a family due to lifestyle choices like smoking and eating habits. For this reason, creating a family medical history is an important step in maintaining good personal health for any individual. A family medical history includes information on any ailments or illnesses that you have experienced or that are present in your family members. These conditions might range from common allergies to potentially preventable conditions like high blood pressure, or even mental or emotional issues like depression or alcoholism. A family medical history could be organized in a chart or table, perhaps even a pedigree. Once you create a family medical history, it's important to discuss your findings with your doctor. Your doctor might recommend medical tests, lifestyle changes, or even genetic consultation based on the patterns that are revealed by the history. By taking an objective look at your health history and evaluating the patterns that might exist in your family, you are one step closer to achieving and maintaining good personal health.